Who's fighting here? Occupied by Würzburg. Würzburg is... I really don't know these small countries. No idea. Well, it's somewhere there in this region. And there is something happening here also. Denmark is attacking rebels. Oh, Denmark is having some rebel issues there. Denmark's actually losing lying with me. Let's go improve my relations with them. They have huge penalties due to being my rival. And we were in war. Also, they have a claim and casus belli against me, so yeah, that's not good. If we actually got rid of the rivalry with the Danish, we could get so much done with them. But Sturia advancing in Austria is really nice. Where is... Yeah, Sturia is down here. Advancing in the Austria. Yeah, they're kind of making their way in there. Merchants suffering. Our focus on mercantilism is making life hard for our merchants who trade in foreign places. Give them support. Lose diplomatic power. 10. Christoph Leivjansson of Sweden is leaving the Baltic Sea. Let's give them support. It's only 10. It's not huge loss of diplomatic power. That's like a monthly loss. Monthly amount. So, not too bad. Ooh. Muscovy is actually mustering a huge army there. I wonder if they're thinking about attacking me. They are hostile against me, so... Well, they do kinda like me at the moment, but they are a bit hostile. I wouldn't mind if somehow Muscovy got kinda crushed. Lithuania is kinda killing these guys, which I do like. I'm kinda tempted to ally with the Lithuania, because he's a huge border rival with the Muscovy. Scotland still wants an alliance. This is like probably 10th time or something. Denmark is done with the improving. Enemies, Norway, Leinster. Norway, 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 England. I really don't want to get into war against Norway and Denmark at the moment. I do want to conquer the whole of Norway and the whole of Denmark eventually, but at the moment it's not a viable option, especially with my really low manpower. All those wars I was fighting there are really hurting me. Hey Desutek and Happy Chicks, or Vincent. We could improve relations with someone new. So who is a rival with Denmark? Enemies. Scotland. Livonians, Leinster, Bohemia. The Hansa. Oh, the Hansa is screwed. Oh, actually Hansa might be doing well. Let's go improve relations with Hansa. Would be actually nice if I made a royal marriage with Hansa. Can you make a royal marriage with them? Oh, they don't allow, because they are not a monarchy. Shame. I guess I need to make them ally. So we are gonna landlogging the Denmark. I'm trying to make the Mecklenburg as my vassal, and then I'm up here. Norway is kinda there. And if I ally with the Hansa there, it kinda leaves the Denmark there hanging. And I could go and kick the Denmark's ass and make them give up the Norway totally. So Kola is now my part of my country. And I need to turn something into Catholic so I can change the culture. I could actually change the culture up there. 25 diplomatic points, 12 months, sure. That is easy change. Only noble republics can marry of the noble branch of the republic branch. Hansa must be positive with the trade. Yeah, probably. Unheroes. Oh, what is happening here? Poland is totally taking over of Poland and Lithuania are just totally taking over the whole of Livonian Order. It's just going the whole thing. It's the same. You don't own Finnmark. No, not yet. It is part of Norway. We did only get this Jämtland from Norway in the previous war, and we took Holland, Skåne, and Blekinge from Denmark. And I do want to get the Gotland, well, whole of Denmark, the whole Norway, and these Karelia and Kexholm for myself, pretty much. I actually like this move. Get the Livonian Order out of there, Riga, and all of these orders, and then I can do some deals with the Lithuanian. They are Orthodox. So we could do a royal marriage with them, eventually. Actually, we could do royal marriage right now. Hello? Free advisor. Oh no, my advisor died. Ulrich died. National revolt risk. That is decent. Yearly inflation. Let's take a... This guy is amazing, so let's take him. The reduced revolt risk is definitely a good idea. National decisions available. Pass Advancement of Religion Act. Make it legal legal offense for servants and the like to read our Holy Bible. Reserve that right. So we would get missionary strength, but we would lose national revolt. Havel theologian. No. Definitely no. Godly again behind the hands of Danes. And here is Swedishness showing there. I don't want to get a permanent national revolt. Negative bonus from there. For the rest of the game. It was still the 1800s where the game actually ends. And I would get better missionaries, but... yeah. You really don't want that. At least I don't. Let's see. We might have 100 and... Oh yeah, that's almost 200 now. Let's go and stop the relation. Improvement. Wait for my diplomat to come home in a few days. And then we'll offer a vassalization. This is actually the first time I've ever done this. So we'll see how this goes. My queen, Mecklenburg has accepted the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to become our vassals. We now get half of their monthly tax income. Hooray! Nice desert. That kind of sounds interesting to actually hear. Annex vassal. You have no diplomats to send. We have to wait. You may only annex nations which has been your vassal for 10 years. And we haven't peacefully annexed any other vassals. Relation 190 or effects of certain peace resolutions. So we had to wait a couple, actually 10 years until we can actually annex the whole region into Sweden if we want to do it. But they are now our friends there. You are probably on the regulars list and juris. Diplomat is back home. Vassals are countries that are subject to another country. When the leech goes to war, the vassals will also automatically join the war. Vassals also, that's nice, have a military access to the leech country. Cost diplomatic relations to maintain. That's actually bad. Diplomatic relations to maintain. Ah, yes. That kinda sucks. Toby do get some money from them now. And if I go to war with Denmark, that they will help me, which is nice. Invest in new technology. We can get diplomatic technology. Sure. Diplomatic technology level 4. Trade range. We can do docks and marketplaces now. That's great. What was the... Let's see, buildings. We can do armory. Manpower increase. Local recruitment time, local regiment cost. Or we could do... Marketplace, already built, in Stockholm. Why? Strange. And the docks. Why can't we do docks here? Where was the docks? There's the dock. Not enough. Ah, we need a diplomatic power to actually build this. So we get local trade power and local ship repair. How well would dock work here? Local trade power. Dunno. Hey, Magara. This is actually a really great name. I love it. If I had to guess, Magara is a Finnish guy. Or from Finland. Look at the docks at Göteborg and Malmö. Is Malmö here? No, it's Kalmar. Lund. Hofstad. Skara. Linköping. Yeah, seems there's a lot of docks I could do. All of them seem to be pretty much the same. Welcome back, Wyatt. Small and ready present. Nice. So this is where Fluffy Holland and Scone. Yeah, I'm bad with the geography and here, so it's easier if you say the province. Not today at least, Wyatt. Actually, I'm probably stopping soon. It's already almost 1 in the morning for me. Local trade power. I should probably... Star button. Oh. Providence of Lapland now has culture that we desire. Nice. And alliance offer from Hansa. That is something I'm actually interested, but... They have a truce, they have war with Brunswick. Brunswick is probably next to Hansa somewhere. Brunswick, where are you guys? Brun. Slunberg. Where is the Brunswick? Brunsburg. Frankfurt. There. Hanover. Oh, you guys are actually pretty large. And allied with Poland and Lunenburg. Actually, this could get me nicely with the Poland. Embargoed by Norway and Brandenburg. Yeah. How about the Brunswick? Let's see. Are you allied with anyone? Munster. Yeah, you are kinda screwed. Royal marriage. I'm gonna offer accept this alliance. Yeah, definitely, Hitchell. Playing something like this definitely will teach you a lot of geography. Hey, spouse, Callum, Moor, and Maliptail. Oops. Thuringia. Thuringen, was it? Thuringia. Oh, well, it's the same place. Who? Smuggleberg. I'm so bad with this. Just cannot see where the hell this country is. Saxony. Allied with Magdeburg. I cannot see where the Thuringia is. It's like there. Oh yeah, that one. All these small countries that wanna be my friends now. Hope I'm above Saxony. I really don't know these small regional countries, especially the historical ones, because I do study history myself, but I'm more archaeology. And when I'm studying the region, there is no countries, there's barely people in general in the Iron Ages and those. No thanks. Actually, yeah. No thanks this time. I lose a lot of... reputation in there, but it's okay. Who are you guys? Pomeranian. You do kinda like me. Brandenburg is actually getting pretty big. So they're probably trying to form Germany there. Siege of Hanover. Attacker. Oh, nice. So Brunswick is actually getting their ass kicked by Hansa. So that's great. So I think Hansa will be taking over those. Yeah, and Huris, there is some really strange decisions with some of the cities for the regions. Osterbotten, where I actually live in Finland. The city in here, this one, should be the city that is the capital of the region. And this is Oulu, or Uleborg, where I actually live. And it actually does show Korsholm, which is not near, even near this location. This is Oulu. And yeah, they definitely screwed this up also. So there is some really strange choices in some of those. You like to play Brandenburg. Nice, Hitchell. Gift to the state. Good governance would sometimes prompt nobility and the businessmen of the realm to donate cash to the treasury out of pure patriotism, or in exchange for the sale or transfer of honorary titles and positions. Get some money, get some prestige. Prestige, please. Yeah, of course, Holm is at Vaasa, which is like somewhere here-ish, I think. Somewhere here. And not there. It's like half of Finland away from the location. So the city location is actually at the correct place, but the city name is just totally wrong. Although Vaasa is also really old and important city in Finland, so I don't know. No idea why they went with Korsholm and not, for example, Vaasa or just Uleborg. Only missed by 300 kilometers, yeah. Just a small margin of error. Do they even have Viborg? Yes, they do, I think. Well, even their location is called Viborg. And most of these are actually correct. Borko for Nyland is correct. Obo for Finland is correct. Tavastehus is correct. This, no idea at all. Savolax for Ulofsborg. Actually, it's Olavinlinna, so it's actually correct too. And up here, no idea. Umeå, Lapland. Kienkas Jarkka. Yes. Although it's on the Sweden side, so no idea about those also. Let's see, we can get new military technology. Arguebus. Hand cannons. Ooh, yes please. Military tactics. Combat with increased infantry shock. That's nice. Oh, Korsholm is older. Ah, well, well, Vaasa is chartered in 130 years, so it makes sense that Korsholm is there at this year. Also, Oulu is much older as well. Oulu 1600s, yeah. Although Oulu did exist way earlier than that, because I've been digging archaeology in Oulu myself, and you do find older stuff than that also. But the city was kind of founded at that year. Successful bureaucracy. On an annual basis, bureaucracy gives the country a little tax boost, but sometimes the right man in the right place can give the country a little bit extra. It is a shame that a few years down the line you have to promote them beyond their ability. Make hay while the sun shines. So we get the 5 years of bonus tax. We are making so much money. It's silly. Which means I'm actually in preparation for the war against evil Norwegians and Denmark, which is going to be happening in the future. I'm gonna get some knights and men-at-arms going. There we go. It's some tiny town you are digging up. Yes, Netquist, it is before it was anything bigger. Military access from Bohemia. Sure. If you guys like it. Oh no, advisor died again. Moral of navies, that's horrible. I would love to get that guy. I could afford him actually. Nice Anhurus. Yeah, there is actually Iron Age stuff and even Stone Age stuff right in here where I live also. So they have lived for a long time in here, in this region. I mean, people have lived here for a long time, but the city actually hasn't existed that long. Although there has been probably some kind of city or town or some kind of dwelling in here for a long time. Although it is understandable because there's a huge river mouth just here, which has been, well, great source of food, transportation, and everything for, well, since Finland has existed pretty much. So it makes sense that people have lived here for a long time. I might regret this decision, but I'm gonna get this guy. I've been also doing some archaeology a bit north of here and also in the inland in here about maybe a bit south somewhere here and it's been nice. We did actually find some really really old stuff from here, like 5,000 year old possibly, one of the oldest, like a Stone Age places in this area. Talk about road here. It hasn't moved until now. Yeah. Roads are always nice. When you dig up those, you find some interesting stuff under them. Building cost. Let's get this. We can get structures cheaper, and we are getting closer to this. Yes, they did a NetQuest. Basically, during the Ice Age, like, most of this was under the ice, and pretty much immediately when the ice kinda moved to north, people just followed after it. So that was my additional army now. I might hire a bit more. We're actually losing money thanks to the army now. I'm gonna kick out the. You are too expensive. And navy model. Yeah, I don't care. Give some more. Austria has declared war on Styria, so we are now better on the. There. Make an army out of those guys, and let's get the leader. It's 50 military power to do it, but we need a new leader. Carl Gustav Kronstedt, you're garbage, but you're a leader. The wolf cave is kinda doubtful. NetQuest, it's among the like archaeology people don't really believe it's a real find. And what I've seen also about the finds from there, they don't look like anything, to be honest. So yeah, the Hansa did take over the Hanover. They did leave the Brunswick there. I was kinda hoping them to grab the whole region and grab this also. What is the Hansa doing, by the way? Truce and pretty much nothing. They're my allies, so I kinda have to keep an eye on them. Okay, just got the relations to max there. And he's back. Let's see where to put him now. Denmark is losing interest in me. Denmark actually doesn't have that great of an army. At least what I can see. Also, the Norway doesn't have that great of an army. Yes, Hansa can turn super powerful. I mean, during the real historic times, Hansa was controlling basically the whole sea area in here, and all the trade. So yeah, I can see them becoming powerful, and I'm actually kind of thinking about getting a Hansa buffer zone against this region there, and kind of controlling this myself. I was actually going to be offering subject of Poland. Oh, so I should go to Poland and offer a royal marriage. They have inferior prestige and legitimacy. Sure. Vassalize Poland. Whole of Poland. Royal marriage. Hooray! As long as you keep them, probably like you. Yeah, but my plan is kind of to get rid of the Denmark as soon as possible. So they like me a lot. Allied to rival. Let's still go improve the relations with those guys. Actually, Lithuania. Yeah. Well, actually, we already were there just a moment ago, so we didn't. We could go improve relations somewhere. Let's go. Let's try with you guys. Actually, I should fabricate some claim. Well, with the Denmark. Actually, do I have... offer an alliance, declare war. Do we have a... take over Gotland. Show superior. We could... they are aligned with Poland and Brandenburg. Yeah, no thanks. Austria having you in England, Poland, Lithuania, Spain. Nice, Hitchell. Hey, Zataru, how's it going? So I'm gonna have to turn Poland against Denmark if I wanna do anything against them. Or get the alliance. Did someone die again? Oh, yeah, the adversary is not there. You're just way too expensive. Total war. I've never really been into the Total War for some reason. Just doesn't feel that good of a game to me. Oh, why is Neva trying to do anything? We have a no, nothing. And you are turning just fine. Culture. Really low. Well, 8% is high, but still low. Do you know how to screw over Denmark, by the way? No, I don't, Netquist. Oops. Improvements in government technology. So they are claiming again how to improve my stuff. So administrative power for inflation or more admin power. Inflation is fine. Admin power is always welcome. Place a fleet on a passage to Sweden. You mean somewhere like here? Can take their capital without inference. Nice. Oh, there's Bjornholm there also. Yeah, but my fleet is garbage compared to theirs. So I need a better fleet to actually do it. Yeah, I should definitely be able to get more ships. Military there. Naval limit. Yeah, I could get 9 more ships. Which I should probably do. Storbald or whatever the part is called. Let's see. Southern Baltic Sea. Oresund. Storbald there. Yeah, probably. They probably don't have that huge fleet anymore. They probably lost a bit of that. You can take all Iceland, Providence of Denmark without interference. Yeah, I should do that when we get the opportunity. Let's get the naval guy. If we are gonna be focusing on naval, and let's build some ships. Early Kazakh bark, or yeah, let's do a couple of those. Takes a year to do a ship. Sure. Plop, plop, and plop. Nice, Hitchell. So yeah, it's gonna take a while to get those ships going and get some money to actually run them. I really need to break the Norway out of Denmark. It's really screwing me. And if I can just get that one dealt, then I'm pretty much golden. Split this actually a bit more. Yeah, one more. Actually, one more. You guys go there. I do have a claim on Gotland if I wanted, so I could get that one fairly easily, and then just smash through there. Holy crap, who has... Oh, the Hansa has a huge army there. Actually, Hansa is my ally and Mecklenburg, so if I go to war against the Denmark, they would help me a ton. This army would crush the whole of Denmark. Easily. We might have a war on our hands really soon. I'm feeling like rattling my sabers across the pond. I just need to get the Denmark's allies dealt with. Brandenburg. Actually, they are kind of annoying there. And to Poland. Let's send a for an alliance. They don't like me. Minus 1,000. Sure. Let's improve some relations with those guys. And I could try to ask Poland to break. No, don't break my royal ties. Offer an alliance. Who are you fighting, by the way, Poland? No one at the moment. I'm gonna offer an alliance to them. So that's gonna be really interesting. Being allied with them. What? Styria against Serbia. And Milan against Styria. There is something really brewing down here. So Poland is now my ally. it's kind of strange to be allied with the Hansa. So we kind of need to kick out the Denmark out of this equation. That Croatia getting bigger. Yeah, there is Croatia pushing there. Oh, there's a war going on there. Oh, it's the Manchester East Frisia. Wasn't Denmark down here also? Yes, Oldenburg. So what happens if I go to war against Denmark now that I'm allied with Poland and they're allied with Poland? So they cannot really support both of us in the war. Skåne is now in our culture and we got the diplomatic power, nice. And we have no mission selected, so we'll be getting some mission soon. Fortify Koala. So we need Earthen Rampart there for 20 manpower and army tradition. That is easy. Papal Controller. Conquer Sjelland. Gain prestige. So we could get the Sjelland there easily. Denmark annexed Holstein. Yeah, they did. Will favor defensive war, they will attack you. Ah. So I should send angry letters to Denmark and make them attack me. Give them middle finger across the pond. And give and shout some obscenities there. Form Scandinavian nation. We need Sjelland, Midjylland, Akers. Where is Akers? Akershus. Sjelland, no, Nordjylland. Akershus is there. Oh, Norway. So we need this one and a couple of the core regions there. And we could do the Scandinavian nation. Eastern border friends, don't know. No, they are friends with Hansa and me and Denmark. And Lithuania is a part of Poland, so they only have friends with me. I kinda need to somehow make the Denmark against me. Yeah, that's gonna go well, Hitchell. I should probably attack like Pomeranian or something instead of angering the Moscow here on this side and making them attack me while I'm trying to find the border actually on this side of the continent. Yeah, that's gonna go super well. How much would the rampart be here? 20-10, sure, let's get that one. That is an easy mission. Accept that culture lost. We no longer care for the people who embrace Danish. Oh.
Great.
Are these guys Danish? No, we... That is Danish. Holland is Danish. They need to turn. And those are Holland. Yeah, let's swap those countries. Not countries, but the regions. You're almost done. Mecklenburg is already my vassal. I have vassalized them already. Yeah, it's a vassal of Sweden. So, they are already my minion. That is why I'm actually kinda interested with the war. Because I know Hansa will join and Mecklenburg will join me. And they kinda block the whole of Denmark from this side. Well, there is that. And kinda lets me just attack from the north and they will help me from the down. Pomeranian. They are in war with Munster. But Pomeranian would be interesting to be my vassal also. Naval supplies, Rejected alliance, they kinda like me, kinda don't. We could do some diplomacy with them. Offer an alliance. Do a royal marriage there. You attack Pomeranian and sell it to Mecklenburg. Yeah, I'm enjoying the game a lot. All these diplomacy things and all this. How to get everyone into total war and chaos. I've been missing out. Who are these guys? Enemies. Riga, Brandenburg, Livonian Order. Yeah, I don't care about you guys. Allied with East Frisia and Lundberg. At this rate, I'll soon have a huge coalition of everyone is allied to some direction, and if there's a war, the whole continent goes into war. So it will be World War One at like 1500 or something at this rate. Yeah, let's do some deals with these guys. Royal marriage with Pomeranians, and let's try to vassalize them also. The Pomerania, there are too many diplomatic relations. Ooh, that's not bad. That is bad. Alliance with the Livonian Order. Yeah, Livonians, you guys might be losing the alliance. Hello. You are on your own now. Affect relations. Yeah, sure. The Poland, Lithuania, and Muscovy coalition is just gonna eat you. And if you go ballistic, I'll just come and kill you myself. So, goodbye. Yeah, broke the alliance. Minus 50. Yeah, they really didn't like that. I don't care. You guys, good luck against the Poland, Lithuania. And you guys, hello Pomerania. How are you guys? Let's do some alliance. How about that? So they are allied with me now, and we can do some improve relations in 2 weeks. Broken ties with Livonian Order, Poland will like me more. Nice. Poland likes me just a bit already. Holy crap. We could almost vassalize Poland. If we actually improve relations with Poland, we could vassalize Poland. We have a royal marriage, we have alliance with them. And we kinda need only... Actually, no. Yeah. Poland has a subsidy of its own. More than total base tax, so they don't wanna be vassal. But we could almost get to vassalize, so they like me a lot. So that's great. If they start losing places, we will vassalize Poland. But yeah, let's improve relations here. And we'll vassalize Pomeranian. They have a strange coalition on this sea. Yeah, they're just a little bit too weak for me. Only spanning from the Baltic Sea to the Black Sea and having the Lithuania there next to them on their own vassal. It is a bit too much, yeah. Are you guys friends with anyone? You're allied with Riga. We could vassalize the Livonian Order. Ships are actually starting to get ready. The ones I've been building for years. There's my heavy ships. If we need to actually do something. I think forced vassalization of a Livonian Order might be actually not a bad idea. Getting Estonians in there and just controlling the whole sea myself. Oops. Improvements in land technology. Our generals are discussing the impact of some new weapons and local gunsmith has been... A local gunsmith has been making. They believe it they can be used effectively in our armies if we get a few more people to work on it. Inflation, military power. Yeah. We can actually do some improvements in a moment also, that's nice. I'm not a war-hungry country at all. This actually... Yeah, that's the scope. But my war finger is kinda itching some direction. Kill the Norway, kill the Denmark, kill the Livonians, conquer Muscovy. We have fortified Kola now. Manpower in there and some army tradition. The mission is done. Spread our culture to Jämtland. Diplomatic power. Are you Norwegians? Yes, you are. Yeah, that's cheap. We'll do it. Achieve religious unity. Ooh, that could be good. But it's gonna take forever. Finnish frontier is asking to be advanced. Yeah, but I'm scared of Muscovy, to be honest. Also, I've no idea what kind of allies they are going with. They have a Golden Horde against them. They have actually no friends. Royal marriage with Perm and this Skov. Warning. Muscovy actually is not allied with anyone. But they have massive armies. And huge manpower. That's 38 against mine of 26. So I need a friend in my war against Muscovy. Which could be actually Poland, Lithuania. How are you guys? Poland has a huge army and Lithuania has a huge army. So if I got Poland and Lithuania to join in the war against Moscow, we could probably do it together. And if I raise a bit more army myself, and I could get the from Finland, wherever it was, from here. Hey, Bitvipers. Poland, Lithuania will probably help. Yeah. Maybe actually, yeah. And we don't have any sea battle issues with those guys or anything. So, and they have no allies on that side. So, let's move these guys into this region. And we'll actually do some war against Moscow. Where's my other diplomat? Switzerland, Syria. Let's see. Ah, come on. Show me the tooltip. Sweden, Brandenburg. And Pomerania. Where is Brandenburg? Oh, this is the Brandenburg. Yeah, you can come home from there. I'm doing quite nicely with Bitvipers. Beware of yeah. Oh, Herald from Pantine. They tell us of peasants' war. The peasantry has been for some time demanded economic, religious and political amendments. Their dissatisfaction has grown to such extent that violent revolts are becoming a common day practice, even though there is no